go over is criterion B, which is your conceptual design. Here's where you start designing your product, because what you should have done in criterion A is come up with the, you know, so basically initially justified the problem, so made sure that it's a problem and highlighted by research, and then come up with your specifications that explain what your product should look like and how it should function and what the safety requirements are, all that stuff. So basically, those are your design constraints. So all your designs and all your conceptual modeling happening in this Criterion B section should be based around those specifications that you've already defined in Criterion A. So we're going to do that, again, looking at Varya and Amani's IAs, two students that did very well on this, and two former ISK students. Amani, I want to say, you know, he got a 7, Varya only got a 5, but they're both, I think, they did a good job, and we'll look at them closer and see what they're missing as well. So the first part, you'll notice that the whole section is 11 pages long. The first section is approximately 6 pages long, which is your... it's a possible design solutions to the problem, and what's important to note is that there's nothing indicated on word count, so they're actually expecting 0 words on there. And remember, obviously you need words and you need annotations, so basically all your words and all your explaining and all the stuff you do should be 10 words or less, because remember, anything that's 10 words or less, anything that's in a table, doesn't count to your words count. So basically what they're trying to say is, in this first section, don't have any extended text, like don't have paragraphs explaining how something functions. So the first part is you're going to generate at least 10 unique ideas, and 10 is just a benchmark that I've given you. You can have more than 10 if you want. I wouldn't have less than 10 designs, just because that doesn't show why, that you've done sort of enough sketching, enough sort of visual brainstorming. Then based on those 10 designs that you've done, you're going to choose 3 to incrementally improve. And work on your conceptual modeling. But for this first section, what I recommend you do is you come up with your 10 designs, and then you choose 3 of them, and those 3 you do in detail using graphical modeling techniques. And you can do it 2 ways. You can either choose an isometric drawing, which again is something that's in a 3D view, and which has the measurements there, as well as all relevant annotations. Or you can do an orthographic, which is again a planar 2D view, which shows your product from different angles. So if we first look at Amani's, let's start with Varya's actually. Let's go down to Criterion B, which is, this is her specification. So she's now started Criterion B. So our first part is coming up with 10 different sketches. Remember, hers is a water dispenser for camping trips. So here she has a sketch. She's got little, very basic dimensions, little annotations of how it might work. Another sketch, basic annotations, dimensions, different designs she's thinking about. And she's done 10 different ones here, how they would work. Some are more realistic, some are less realistic. If we look at Amani's, let's bring his up. Let's go down again. These are specifications. So he's got a sketch with basic annotations, and then he's actually added some little photographs that explains it a bit more. This is probably, should be roughly 10 words. It looks like he cheated a little bit, but basically a little bit about the pros and cons of each design. And that's something I actually recommend that you do anyway, because one of the things that they're going to ask you for, or one of the things in the criteria, is how do your different sketches relate to your initial specifications. So it's okay to put cons there. So you could say, unrealistic, too big, might be too bulky, need to work on this. But basically, the annotations should relate to your specifications. So you see he's saying now adjustable to different sizes, how it disseminates seed balls. So he's got one design there, 2 designs there. And he's not the best artist, so you'll notice that what he tried to do, he tried to sort of, whenever possible, he would sort of, give a couple of angles of how it looks like. But again, this is all just sort of visual brainstorming of how something looks like. This is a design that's going to be attached to a plane, I guess, or maybe this is a drone or whatever. So he's kind of explaining the mechanism there, a walking stick. And how that works. Anyway, you can see pros and cons of each design. So he's got 6 of these different sketches. Okay, The next thing he's going to do is he's going to now choose three of them. As he said, now a design I plan to explore in more detail. So he's saying the wheelbarrow design, the drone design, and the camel design. He's explained why. Ease of repair and ease of cleaning, can be equipped with sensors or whatever. If you look at Varya, same thing. She's saying, I'm going to choose 2, 7, and 8. And she's justifying why she's chosen those three. And you know, based on how they met the specifications. And she's chosen 2, 7, and 8. Okay, looking at Varya. So then once you've done that, decided which of the three you've chosen to develop for, then again, it can be 4, it can be 5. But 3 is the minimum. She now has drawings of how this is going to work. So first one is this push-in nozzle design, and she's got drawings of the mechanism of how it'll work. The next one is this barrel stand design, and she's explained in her case it's kind of a combination between orthographic and isometric. So she's got sort of this one is more isometric. This one, I guess, was more orthographic. But again, very detailed, all the measurements, explaining pros and cons, how it works, all that sort of stuff is there. And then her third one is, again, detailed explanations of how that design works. So she's chosen 3, and then she has 3 detailed drawings of how it looks like. In Amani's case, he's decided to go straight to, I'm trying to see if he has any drawings here. Is it just that, yeah, so here, these are his drawings. He's done orthographic drawings. This is the wheelbarrow design that he's taken further. And he's sort of explained it with measurements and explained how it works. And then he's taken this is the drone design further. And again, he's explained in measurements and stuff. He's chosen Illustrator in this case with annotations of how it really is going to work, detailed views of that. And then I'm going to skip this because this is the rest of his modeling. And then the last one is his camel design. And the same thing, the drawings are here, how it's going to work. And he's done a really good job of explaining it in the context of a camel and that sort of stuff and how that all works. So these are his three designs taken further. Okay, the next part is sort of the first section. The second section is approximately four A4 pages. And what that is your conceptual modeling. And so here is where you want to show different modeling techniques. And what I tell students is that really what you want to show is you want to have at least a physical model for each. And by physical model, it can be a 3D print of your design. It can be a cardboard model of your design. It could be using something like clay, or I'm trying to think what other modeling techniques. You could do something using, recycled materials, or you could be building out of wood, but basically something that you can test physically, so somebody can actually do some user testing on. And then you also want to have a CAD model, something that's rendered on the computer that you can again use to do some 3D renderings of, how different parts slot into each other and how they actually work as a whole. So you want to have a physical model, a CAD model, and then you also want to have your graphical model, but that you've already done, hopefully, in detail from the first section. And then the most important part in this section is that you're showing the results of your testing, and you're showing that you're doing different iterations of your model. So you don't want to just show a physical model and say, great, I've done a physical model. What you want to do is show a physical model and then show how you've had to change your physical model based on your testing. So if we look at, let's look at Amani's example, because I seem to remember he did a great job. So let's just look at, for example, let's go up again. So actually this is a good example. So this is his drone designs. He's got sort of a sketch of how it looks like and how it's going to work. This is a graphical model we talked about. Then here he's got a 3D rendering of how this mechanism of dispensing seed ball is going to work. He's got a 3D printed. This is his physical model of how this mechanism is going to work. And you can see that basically based on this, he says not all of them are perfect spheres. He said, at first I thought the circular holes would be the most ideal for the seed ball, but then ended up jamming up. So now he's changing his designs. You see what he's done? He's now making them sort of straight to test out the difference. He's prototyping him, he's testing out, and now he's changing his design based on what he's finding out in his tests. And he's done it, you know, a couple of ways. So now he turns out it was jamming up, so now he's made a modification up here in terms of something that helps it not jam up. And he's sort of explaining the results of this and how that would work. And you can see it's sort of based on, now he's changed his design totally. Now he has sort of a gumball mechanism based on the fact that it was jamming up. He's shown how that design changed. Same with this camel one. You'll see that, you know, his initial one looked like this. He's tested it out and he's found that actually, you know, he needs to change certain aspects of it. Based on his modeling on this, and if we look at Varia's over here, same sort of thing. She's got a physical here. She's got her CAD models and how it works, you know, she'll talk about what the problems with it is and how she's changed her design on that. So if you look at that, and she's got sort of her mechanisms. So again, what they want to see is evidence of modeling, and most importantly, evidence of how your design is updated and changed based on your modeling. And then the last thing in here is you're going to evaluate your design based on your all your specifications. So choose one of your designs based on your specifications. And what I recommend is that you do it for all three, because basically you've done three designs, you've done modeling on all three, so now it's a chance for you to evaluate all three and say which one you're going to choose based on how they meet the specifications. So we look down here in Amani's case, what he's done. Let's see how he's done it. He's basically said, you know, he's got a specification, and then he said, you know, the three designs here, and then whether they're met or not. And if they're not met, he's explained why they're not met. So you'll see, you know, he's going through it. So he's basically justifying each of these specifications, which one they've not met, and if they've not met, why they haven't met. So that's the way he's chose to do it. And then in Varia's case, if we look at hers, she has done it slightly differently, but in a similar way. She's got her three designs, and she said, you know, she's given them a ranking at the bottom of how they've met or how they've not met. And given reasons, you know, why they've met or why they've not met. So basically justified the score that she's given them. And then the final thing in here, if you look down here, is in criterion A, is a presentation drawing of your chosen design. For that presentation drawing, what that is a rendering, a 3D rendering of a chosen design, something that you might show to somebody, to like, you know, to a potential client, to show what your design is going to look like. And what they're looking for is a nice 3D rendering of your design with annotations. So this is Varia's final design, explaining, you know, different features of it, of, you know, how it looks like. If we look at Amani's over here, similarly, he's got his final design and explaining different features of his design and how it's going to work. And that's the final presentation drawing. So that is it from criterion B. If we look at the rubric, again, we're going to move down here to the tabs. I'm going to go into criterion B, and you'll see that I've given you a very detailed rubric that explains it. And if you're missing something, I'm going to highlight what you're missing. So for example, if I feel that you can do more work on your annotations and they're not legible, I might highlight that in red so that knows that you need to work on that. And then you're going to get a score down here, letting you know in which of the mark bands you currently are placed. And again, this is one thing that, again, I can't stress enough, is that you're, like in this section, you're saying, so indicates how the findings from modeling informs your design development. So that's important. They want to see iterations. They want to see how you're modeling and then changing your design based on that modeling. And again, you want to have examples of conceptual models, which is your sketches and stuff you've done, graphical models, you know, your drawings, physical models, which is your you know, your either cardboard or 3D prints, and your CAD models. Okay, that's it from criterion.